Outlaws, Rockets, and Quotes in the Kings of Birds. We use movies and words such as Thrust, Lift, Drag, and Propulsion to help us figure out the treatment. A quote that we really liked was, Rocket science is tough and rockets have a way of failing by Sally Ride, because it shows that rocketry is tough and no one can succeed all the way. We chose a wide rocket body because we thought that would let more air come in and push it up. We have big fins and cardboard fins because we didn't know it would make it weigh so much. We have three fins because we thought it would make it weigh less and balance. We had a wide nose cone because we had a wide body, and also it wasn't that sharp because the wide nose cone caused it not to be sharp. We wrapped paper around the PVC pipe tightly so it wouldn't unravel when it was being launched. For the nose cone, we outlined a circle on a piece of paper, and then we cut it out, then cut the circle like quarter up, then folded it, then made the nose cone. Then we taped it. We cut cardboard into the shape of our fins, which looked like that. We taped everything except for the hot glue, the fins, which had to be used by a hot glue gun, or else they would fall when they were being launched. For launch for Rocket One, we had jobs. Charlotte was the placer and launcher. Ivy was the countdown master and receiver, and I was the air comforter. We had high expectations for a rocket launch because we kept trashing our other rockets, and we thought this one was the most stable. It didn't go high because it was very heavy with cardboard fins and how big the rocket was. And the air pressure, we didn't know how high the air pressure would go. The air pressure obviously went higher than a rocket kind of would have went higher. So if it went higher than 50 degrees, it would. This is a video of a rocket launch. Launch one. The pros were that we knew what we can do for the following rocket launches 2 and 3, so we weren't that nervous. We were lucky that our rocket went off the launch pad because not all the rockets went off the launch pad. We had 3 fins to keep it stabilized, and the cons were the rocket was heavy, so we had 2 big fins, cardboard fins, long body, and the tape was too tight. We had one of the lowest scores. For Rocket 2, we got inspired by a different class that had no nose cone, which had tape over the top and paper fins, so it caused less drag. So we decided to do that, but we needed a nose cone. So we taped the top, and then we put a nose cone on top, so it looked like we had a nose cone too. We had 3 fins because we thought it was stabilized, and we had a totally different look from Rocket 1 because our body was different, our nose cone was different, and our fins were different.
We rolled paper around the PVC pipe tightly so it wouldn't unravel while it was launching. We taped the top of the rocket and put a nose cone on top so has sharp nose cone because so it can cut through the air. We have skinny body because when we had a wide body, it was really bad, and skinny bodies. We made paper fins because it could weigh less.
Rocket launch number two. We all had jobs. I was the air pumper, Gabby was the countdown master retriever, and Ivy was the rocket placer and launcher. We had a big improvement from the first launch to the second launch. One reason is our rocket went high and our first rocket failed. I think what changed was, like, helped us was the nose cone. It was easier, and the fins. The nose cone was easier to cut through the air, and the fins were lighter, so it weighed less.
Eric got the rocket too. We had to draw a line between the 245s, and that we had to add all of our kilometer readings, and then divide it by four, and then whatever that number was, we had to mark it on the protectors on the side and draw it up, and wherever it met in between, that was our thing. That was our height, and we got 30 meters, and we had to add 1.5 because that's an average height of a fifth grader, and that's 31.5 meters, and feet is 103 feet.
The pros for the rocket launch number two is that it shot up really high compared to the launch number one. It was 10 meters higher than launch number one, which is really good. We knew what we could do for the third launch. We wanted to do paper fins again and no nose cone. And it was like a really good launch. The cons were that it didn't go as high as we thought. And it was really sunny, so it was hard for the kilometer readers to see.
Designed for rocket fins. We put little tape so it wouldn't cause drag. We had three paper fins to keep it stabilized, and the paper fins would weigh less. We had no nose cone, and we taped the top of the rocket, as you can see, and we made sure no air could get through.
Building rocket three, we rolled the paper on our PVC pipe. We used a skinny body because for rocket number two launch, we used a skinny body, and it was better than one, which had a wide body, so we decided to use that again. We taped where most air can go through because if we launched it and we didn't tape where most air could go through, all the air would go, like, out, and our rocket wouldn't go. We taped the top of the rocket because this time we were allowed to not use a nose cone, so we took that advantage and used it. We blew air into the rocket to test it because the top, we weren't really sure about it because we didn't know if there was going to be holes so the air could go through, but we didn't know. We cut paper into triangular fins like this because we thought it was the best shape for it.
We rotated jobs. I was the air pumper, Charlotte was the countdown master, and Gabby was the launcher. We had a good feeling about this rocket launch because it was our third rocket launch, and we did go to the second one, so we were really. We had high expectations because we had no nose cone, and it was a good launch.
Graph number three. For our graph, we found the average. We got 36.5, so we found 36 on the protractor on both sides. Then we drew a line, then where connected is where we make. And then we got 36 there also. Then we because we have to add 1.5 because that's the average height of a fifth grader, and we got 38 meters. In feet, 125 feet.
Her reflection, her pros is that our rocket succeeded because it was like the best rocket of all of my new rockets. No nose cone was better because the air wouldn't have shot right into the nose cone, it would have just stayed in the rocket. Paper fins caused less drag because the cardboard fins were heavier, so the paper fins weighed less. The small body was like better because it directed it well and how it was very short. The skinny rocket body did well because it kept most of the air in also. It made a great ending for our rocketry unit because it was the best rocket of all of our three. Our cons were we needed more thrust to lift our rocket better. We had too much tape that it made it a little more heavy, and there was no decoration at all.
We did well for all the launches. We agreed and didn't fight. We had great rocket launches.
We worked well together. We agreed on most of the things. We had three great launches, and we tried all different techniques: wide body and skinny body, cardboard and paper fins, sharpened, not sharp nose cone, and no nose cone. We didn't argue that much, and we did a great job.